Greetings all from Sudan. First, let me thank the IPAC for the invitation to be part of this very important webinar. And let me first give general things that I believe that is crucial when we speak about the adaptation in general. We know that the world is already experiencing changes in average temperature, shifts in the season, and increasing frequency of extreme weather events and other climate change impacts, and slow onset events. The faster the climate change and the longer adaptation efforts are put off, the more difficult and expensive it could be. As we mentioned, and we know all, Africa counts for less than 4% of global emission. But still, its population are facing the worst consequences of the climatic crisis. If we refer to the impact of climate change on extreme weather, food and water resources at 1.5 special IPCC special report, the report shows that 1.5 degrees centigrade of warming is not just a limit for our countries. It is a limit for everyone. The escalating impacts that our country is facing today are being felt by vulnerable populations around the world. And slowed economic growth to biodiversity loss and extra. The report also outlined the substantial risk for all us, for all of us, if we were to exceed 1.5 degrees centigrade, particularly for our countries. The IPCC in its report has made it very clear throughout this report, there is a huge differences between 1.5 and 2 of warming. The longer we leave it, the more expensive, dangerous, and difficult this will be. Mr. Chair, if allow me also, before go to the experience of Sudan NAB, let me say that adaptation is the adjustment in ecological, social, and economic system in response to actual or expected climatic climatic effect or impact. So in simple terms, countries and communities need to develop adaptation solution and implement action to respond to the impacts of climate change that already happening and as well as prepare for future impacts if we are not take ambition action. Adaptation solution also, as we know, take many shapes and form depending on the unique context of the community, business, organization, country, or region. There is no one-size-fits-all solution for adaptation. So if we come to the Sudan, like other African countries, IGAD countries, LDCs countries, is already experiencing the impact of climate change. Over the past three decades, climate change can lead to the crop failure in traditional rain-fed farming, which is a backbone for the Sudanese economy. It has also led to severe impact to pastoralist activities, such as deterioration of natural range land and increasing in the seasonal fire, overgrazing in communal land and livestock deaths. So all these impacts giving the profound poverty in the across the rural community in Sudan. The vulnerability and risk assessment done by Sudan shows that at Sudan's 18 states, there are the impacts and the impacts of the climate change are identified in the reduction in the ecosystem integrity and resilience, and also decline in the crop suitability. and also decline in crop and gum yields, and also impacts on the livestock production. For Sudan, climate change represents significant threat to food security and sustainable development. With more than 70% of the population depend on sectors and systems that are highly vulnerable to the climate change, and which Sudan that identified these sectors in, when preparing the National Adaptation Plan for Action in 2007. Until now, Sudan faced difficulties and challenges to finance the priorities in to finance the implementation of the NAP, the urgent and immediate action need in the large scale. It's just pilot project, and this is why one of the core issues in the upcoming COP that always as the African countries we put in front of our face and in front of our position, that the adaptation issue and the means of implementation to implement a serious and to provide the means of implementation for the adaptation actions in our countries. Sudan also is the one of the fairest countries that adopt the national adaptation plan. And by the way, this is the one of the agenda item in the SPI. And the countries reflect many challenges and barriers regarding even the preparation of the national adaptation plan. And as well as who the few countries that prepare the national adaptation plan, like Sudan, is still since 2016 is still looking for the finance and the financial resources to fund the implementation of the NAP. And if you consider that also, the NAP process established since 2010. You see that since 2010 in COP 16 by the Cancun framework, adaptation framework. So the adaptation, the national adaptation plan of the Sudan has emerged as the central policy framework for the proposing need action by the government in reshaping its current program and protocol to ensure the adaptation and climate risk management are integrated into the wider Sudanese sustainable development planning process. And then we identified the priorities, adaptation priorities in each state and in each sectors. And the Sudan app also, it is as the input for our updated NDCs, because previously it is built or based upon the national development plan as well as the vulnerable sectoral policies and plan. But still Sudan faces that is a very limited internal resources to implement adaptive measures to reduce the acute weight stress, deepening food insecurity, expansion of vector born diseases and biodiversity losses. Because on the other hand, due even to the uncommitment from the developed countries and that provide the finance and other means of implementation. Also, Sudan, on the other hand, due to the long-lasting economic and political sanction, only recently lifted after 2019 revolution. So access to the finance has been largely restricted to multilateral institutions like GEF through the allocated, very few allocated funds, and GCF, leaving Sudan even more vulnerable to the devastating consequences of climate change impacts on its people and natural system. But even though Sudan in a very limited way in a pilot project, implementing some key urgent and immediate adaptation initiatives as identified based in the NABA as well as in the labs through the GCF, LDCF, and GIF. Kair, if has 1 minute, if I have 1 minute still, I can just say that we need large scale risk informed preventive and systematic adaptation effort to protect people and communities and to build high resilience in future. We need easier access to public finances and expanded the debate relief initiative are urgently needed for these countries. The need also lastly for a unified African voices and common African position. Thank you.